Good evening and welcome to St. Paul's Church in Nantucket. We have Joe Hammer, our music director, with us tonight. Jackie McGrath, our young soloist, with us to sing. Thanks for joining us as we honor those who gave their lives so we could be worshiping together tonight for our freedoms. We give thanksgiving. After some opening prayers, our hymn will be hymn number 579 in your hymnal. 579, we sent out that hymn earlier. You'll know it's based on the Navy hymn. We have some opening prayers now. This is a collect for heroic service. O judge of the nations, remember before you with grateful hearts the men and women of our country and all the countries of our allies who in the day of decision ventured much for the liberties we now enjoy. Grant we may not rest until all the peoples of this land share the benefits of true freedom and gladly accept its disciplines. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
This next piece is entitled Eulogy, written by Everett Tickham, who was an American composer, 20th century. You'll notice that in the middle of the piece, he uses the Gregorian melody for In Paradisum, It's in the middle section, and it has that tune for centuries has been sung at the conclusion of the burial office. And here's a translation. May the angels lead thee into paradise, and the martyrs receive thee at thy coming and bring thee into the holy city Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels receive thee, and mayest thou, with Lazarus once poor, have everlasting rest.
Thank you.
as we honor those who have died in war. Our comfort is that we trust that they dwell with God, that they're in God's protection. And pray now the 91st Psalm. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High abides under the shadow of the Almighty. He shall say to the Lord, "You are my refuge and my stronghold, my God in whom I put my trust. He shall deliver you from the snare of the hunter and from the deadly pestilence. He shall cover you with his pinions. You shall find refuge under his wings. His faithfulness shall be a shield and buckler. You shall not be afraid of any terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day, of the plague that stalks in the darkness, or of the sickness that lays waste at midday. 1,000 shall fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Your eyes have only to behold to see the reward of the wicked. But because you have made the Lord your refuge, and the Most High your habitation, there shall no evil happen to you. Neither shall any plague come near your dwelling. For God shall give his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. They shall bear you in their hands, lest you dash your foot against the stone. You shall tread upon the lion and adder, shall trample the young lion and serpent under your feet. Because he is bound to me in love, says the Lord, therefore I will deliver him, or protect him, because he knows my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I am with him in trouble. I'll rescue him and bring him to honor. With long life will I satisfy him and show him my salvation." It was only in recent years that I heard the expression of Gold Star family. But I grew up visiting my grandmother, my dad's mother, and when we went into her foyer of her house, there was always a table there on the side that had a portrait of my Uncle John and a purple heart. And maybe just a little plant, you'd have an African violet or a little plant there. My Uncle John is one that he's a Boston police officer, my family, Boston natives. And he joined the Army Air Force on the same day my dad joined the Army, and they went off in different directions, and he didn't return. He was shot down. Only his fourth run, he was in the Army Air Force co-pilot, and they ended up being shot down and landed in the ocean. Half the crew survived, three survived, and the others died, including my uncle. Just found out recently, he and the pilot, whose family, the pilot's father was one of the president maybe of Dr. Pepper. We have all these letters to my grandmother with Dr. Pepper stationery. Matter of fact, I think it was called Jenny Pepper, the plane that my uncle flew on after the pilot's family, Dr. Pepper. And so Uncle John, I found out that the pilot and the co-pilot were engaged to be married to sisters that they had met when they were in training together, sadly, and didn't return. And then the flowers are given, today, beautiful flowers for this weekend, for Memorial Day, in memory of Dual McIntyre Sr., who died over in Africa in 1944. Blessedly, it had left a young family, sadly for the family, but blessedly for us, Dual McIntyre Jr., who just passed away recently at age 80. A beautiful life, honoring his dad's name and the way he lived so honorably. And so we celebrate all families, whether their loved ones come back or not, have paid such a sacrifice when we send our men and women off to war. And of course, it's so dangerous, just the training itself, whether our loved ones die in training or in battle, it's such a loss. With my uncle, we wondered what could have been, you know, if the young man had come back. Again, we need to live our lives in a way that honors. I'm so blessed that my uncle's buried in Margraten Cemetery in the Netherlands. And only recently, my brother John, through the wonders of Facebook, met online the person that has adopted my uncle's grave years ago and tends to that grave. The citizens in that area, the locals, adopt the graves after all these years to thank the Americans and the other Allied troops for the freedoms that they enjoy. And so it's something that maybe we could be good to honor our loved ones in that way, wouldn't it? And here's this is from the Abraham Lincoln's, you recognize this from the Gettysburg Address. This is from November 19th, 1863. It was rather for us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us, that from these honored dead, we take increased devotion for which they gave the last full measure of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, that this nation under God shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth. Amen to that.
Day is done, gone the sun, from the hills, from the lake, from the skies, all is well, safely rest. God is nigh. Go to sleep, peaceful sleep. May the soldier or sailor God keep. on the land or the deep, safe in sleep. Love, good night, must thou go when the day and the night need thee so? All is well, speedeth all to their rest. Thanks and praise for our days, 'neath the sun, 'neath the stars, 'neath the sky. As we go, this we know, God is
nigh. Pray for the families that grieve. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage. May have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. This we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Our hymn now is hymn number 718 in your blue hymnal, if you have it at home, 718.
Thank you.
Father of all, we pray to you for all those we love, but see no longer. Grant them your peace, that light perpetual shine upon them, and your loving wisdom and a mighty power work in them the good purpose of your perfect will. We pray this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, make you perfect every good work to do God's will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in God's sight, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you now and remain with you always. Amen.
Good night, everyone.